Hi there, Natsukimura here. Previously, you have learned access token and refresh token. But there's yet another kind of tokens in OAuth 2.0. Let's check it out. In OAuth 2.0, there's a string called Authorization Code that is passed from authorization server to the client through a browser. It's not typically mentioned as a token in OAuth context, but it is a token. It embodies the authorization that was granted by the resource owner. It's typically a sender-constrained token. It's bound to the client ID, and the client has to show that it is him when using the authorization code. So, even if the authorization code was stolen, it's not a big deal. Why do we use such an extra step before issuing an access token? There are a few reasons for it, but the biggest one is the communication involving the resource owner typically goes through the browser, and thus the communication is not entirely protected, and token issued through it can be stolen. This means that sending the bearer token, whether it's a client secret or access token, over this channel is a very bad idea. So in OAuth 2.0, we are using a sender-constrained token called Authorization Code in this channel.
That was 2 minutes. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't yet.